better hit that subscribe button.
What is going on, ladies and gentlemen of the internet and YouTube? I'm Freddy Fuego, Flaming Hot Entertainment, MultiPlatGameTrap.com, the people's voice and your favorite average gamer. Today, going to be giving you a gaming update, channel update, revised, everything's basically on the table. I'm going to be live streaming a lot more. I have a game in mind that I want to live stream. It's a four-person co-op game that a lot of you subscribe to my channel for, which was Ghost Recon Future Soldier for the PlayStation 3, and I'm going to be doing a live stream starting hopefully tonight, maybe tomorrow. I have to actually get the crew gathered to find out when we're going to be actually streaming it. Everybody's free and not working and stuff like that. Another thing is going to be pumping out a lot more videos, probably two a day, back on my grind. I've been MIA for a while, had stuff I had to do. Anyways, gaming updates, gameplay videos, constantly, barrage, like I'm a hustler on the block trying to sell whatever, two for fives all day. So we're going to be doing that. My Twitch TV is, in the description. Remember to go follow me at Twitter, at FREDEFLAME. That's Freddy Flame. Link will be in the description. Make sure you go check out the last two videos. Links will be in the description. We were talking about 1080p, 60 frames per second, becoming the new industry standard for console and what that means for us console gamers and even to the PC gamer, because the restraints of the consoles holding the PCs back is pretty much almost over with. When you're talking about this generation, the Xbox One, the Wii U, and the PlayStation 4, not holding back, PC development and them being able to do more on the PC. But this generation is starting off with a blast. Battlefield 4, Killzone, Shadowfall, Drive Club. I even believe Rise, Son of Rome is going to be in 60 frames. So all these 60 frames is definitely the new, it should be the new standard. Everything should be at 60 frames. Now we talked about native 1080p resolution or upscaling via hardware or software on the consoles. So anyways, that's awesome news for gamers in general. There's more on that in that video. Tell me what you think about that video and go check it out. Now, on this note, as you see, I have the green screen behind me. Definitely going to be using this bad boy more. I'm going to be doing On the Stoop. Most likely, I don't know, I'd probably do Sunday On the Stoops in front of my building with my Samsung Galaxy S4 active. All right, so we talked about the 1080p, the 60 frames being the new industry standard and what most game developers are shooting for, which is awesome for us gamers, awesome for console gamers, awesome for the PC as well. Like I said, less restraints on the PC, and PC can actually move forward and push, hardware to its limits and get better hardware eventually in the future. This channel has been stagnant for a while. I do apologize for it. Thank you for the support where I haven't been making videos. I got tons of videos. I've got over 1,000 videos that I've uploaded, and I've deleted probably about 500 of them due to copyright problems or just in general stuff that I wanted to take down that had material that shouldn't have been in the videos. So I've gotten a whole bunch of views over even in this stagnant time, and I would like to just say thank you very much to the haters, the supporters, everybody. A view is a view, regardless. A comment's a comment, whether it's hateful or supportive. A thumb up or thumb down or like or dislike back in the days was it doesn't really matter. Your opinion, what you want to do. And thank you for that. And basically, I'm on my grizzy, exactly like I said a couple seconds ago. But I'm back, and it's going down. We're going to be streaming a lot more. I've actually started streaming. I've streamed more on my Twitch account, which is Freddy Fuego, just like this channel that you're watching right now. So you can go follow me on Twitch, like me, favorite, all that good shit on there too. For those of y'all that do all the social media madness, links will be at the bottom of the description. Last two videos and all that good shit. Anyways, we are talking about now, right now, the fanboys. The fanboys are rampant. I mean, in general. And I don't pay attention to them. I do laugh at them and just see the humor in it all. And I put up some fanboy parody videos. So if you haven't checked those out, I will leave those in the description as well. So go check those out. And there were three that were done at three different times, and then I turned them into one, so you could watch it all at one time. And I'll leave that link for that one in the description. It's about 30 minutes. They were like 10-minute skits a piece, condensed into 30 minutes. And it's just how I view fanboyism, and
my
it's
name
just
is
stupid.
Abigail Walker, but my friends and enemies
now
call me
on
Fetch.
Onto the more
I've
gaming
never heard an innocent
topics
person
and
in my
news.
Life.
Witcher 3 is coming to the PlayStation 4. I'm sure it's coming to the Xbox One. Xbox One is rumored to come out November 8th. I just finished saying that. I don't know if I'm getting the Xbox One on release if it comes out November 8th.
That's 2 out of 3.
That money right for that time. I'm set for different dates. And I might have to cancel that pre-order. But I'm working on it. I'm working on it. Definitely trying to get that and fulfill my promises and what I want to do with that. I am not going to be making videos to bash the Xbox One. I will always talk shit and say Microsoft's a shit company, and the facts prove that. But you know, a piece of hardware doesn't really fucking do anything. It's the people behind it that fuck it up. But they've changed, and I know they got a new CEO, a female CEO. They fired their old CEO, or he left. Microsoft, the gaming division of Microsoft, which is the Xbox, and they hired a new female, and
yours,
everything's been overturned, 180, seems like they're going to be getting more indie games, and just in general, it's a step in the right direction, and what I would like to see is that 1 year, or maybe 2 years of just consistency coming from Microsoft, and customer appreciation from them. And that's what I'm just getting. Like I said, I'm getting a review copy of the Xbox One, and I'm not going to keep it. You know, they haven't sold me on anything. It's not something that, it's not the brand that I like or anything like that. It's nothing to be a fanboy about. I'm going to get it and give it a fair review when I get it. And that's what it's going to be just basically about. It's going to be fairness. You know, personal opinions, I'll leave to my vlog videos on the stoop Sundays. You can catch them. And, other than that, you know, talk about Nintendo. Nintendo's got a 2DS game console coming out, and it, for one thing, it doesn't have 3D. Obviously, it's a 2DS. It's backwards compatible for all DS and 3DS and everything. I'll play the games. The only thing doesn't have the 3D little button or whatever, and it doesn't have the clamshell. It's thicker. It's bigger. It's more encumbersome. You can't actually shut it on itself and protect the screens. It looked like it came with a zipper carrying case. I thought it was bullshit. I thought it was a fake. I thought you know, trolls. It's actually real. Then I watched a couple videos from, you know, fellow YouTubers like Broken Games HD, Home P, and shout outs to them too. If you haven't checked out their channels, links will be in the description as well. And it's the real deal. And Xbox in the US, I mean, not Xbox, sorry, Wii U in the United States is going to get a $50 price drop. They're phasing out the 8 gig models and are just going to be selling the 32 gig deluxe models. I don't know if they're going to have them in white too, or they're just all going to be black. But that's a good thing. Nintendo seems like they're actually moving in the right direction when it comes to, nobody expected them to do a price drop. I didn't expect them to do a price drop. I'm sure other YouTubers have said they didn't expect them to do a price drop. I said this is what we would have liked it, but we didn't see this coming. On top of that, you know, there is getting fragmentation when it comes to the hardware. So they have to do a lot of good marketing to get people to understand that Nintendo's vision for themselves And that's where they need to do. They need better marketing. They need better promotion. They need to get people to understand that the Wii U is not just an attachment, a gamepad attachment for the Wii, that is actually its own console. And they're going to be doing a Wind Waker HD remake. It's not a remake. It's just a re-envisioning. It's not like they took all the... They're basically built the whole thing from scratch. Again, but in HD and just to fit the Wii U, it's going to be bundled with the new Wii U. It's going to have a Wii U bundle. So that probably costs like $350, which is great. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to agree with Broken Games HD on his video when he talked about this. I think they should have put out a better exclusive, maybe new Super Mario Brothers Luigi U, or I don't know, something, maybe even Bayonetta, you know what I'm saying? Bayonetta or The Wonderful 101. Oh no, that game, I love Zelda and everything, but that one wasn't one of the ones that I liked. I'm old school, Link to the Past type guy, you know what I'm saying? That was my favorite Zelda game ever. But anyways, or give us a new updated, you know, Link looking fucking ultra graphics and fucking new physics engine and shit like that, like that demo they did at E3 and PAX and all that shit. Fucking, that is the game we want for Zelda. That's the fucking game. I got a Wii U. My wife is a Nintendo fan, and I wanted to see Nintendo's take on adult gaming, which I've yet to see right now. There's no Nintendo game that's like an adult gaming game coming from their first party studios, Retro or whatever. Bayonetta's a third party exclusive. So I'm talking about, I want to see Nintendo's their take on adult gaming, and that's what's going to get me to buy them games. I have yet to buy a game since I bought the three games that I bought when it launched, which was Call of Duty Black Ops 2, Zombie U, and New Super Mario Brothers U, and it came with Nintendo Land. So that's what I want to see from Nintendo. I definitely want to see. It's going to be a year before you see the actual games come out that you want to see, them first party titles that are awesome. And then you got no more bad news from Nintendo for fans of the Mario Kart 8. Yeah, it's Mario Kart 8, and then the new Super Smash Brothers for the Wii U and the 3DS. That's not... One of those is not going to have a campaign, which is the Smash Brothers. And then the Mario Kart game that you thought would have had online multiplayer is not going to have online multiplayer. So for me, those two games, off-rip, fail. Just fail. It's we're in next generation, you know what I'm saying? Everybody can steal Wi-Fi. Everybody's got fucking routers or fucking modems or cable modems in their house or whatever. So Nintendo needs to step up for this generation. We're not talking about you stepping up to the plate on the 3DS. We're talking about the fucking Wii U. We're not talking about the Wii. We're talking about the Wii U. Even the Wii had online multiplayer when it came to the last Mario Kart that they had out. So, and that's just stupid. Anyways, that's pretty much it for this video. I've been your host, your commentator, Freddy Fuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, MultiplatGameTrap.com. The people's voice and your favorite average gamer. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming.
Thumb up the video, fool!